every day. I'm hanging all the time, all day long.
Where's my phone at?
Every gym in every city.
Can you show me the ring? Show that motherfucker out. That's 1.5.
That's it?
That's it. I have his phone.
Check this out, guys. Ryan Garcia has a new girlfriend, and he just bought a ring for her, and you'll see the video. He buys a ring for her. The same amount of money that he gave Devin Haney for missing weight is what he bought this his new girlfriend a ring for. The ring is $1.5 million, and you'll see it. If they're in a Tiffany store, and it's $1.5 million and 63,000, and they all joke when she says 63,000. So here's Ryan with his new girl. He's very, very popular. He bet $2 million on himself to win back $12 million. So he has some money to spend. He has some money to waste over here. And he's having a good time. So check out this video of Ryan Garcia buying his girl a $1.5 million ring.
Crazy.
This is the best ring you could possibly get.
Get perfect. In the whole world. In the whole world.
How much is the ring?
The total cost is $1.5 million and a little change is $63,550.
There you
so
go.
What's the whole total?
This whole fight weekend was a movie. It could be a feature film. It could be a Hollywood movie, just like the movie Rocky, just like the movie The Fighter. Just follow Ryan's antics from the moment they announced this fight to fight night. And he wasn't playing. He was drinking. He was having a good time. He wasn't taking the camp as seriously as he could have, or this fight would be over in 10 seconds, maybe 30 seconds. That first punch he landed, it would have ended the fight if Ryan took this seriously as he, but in the end it all worked out for him. So what does it matter? He was drinking. He said he had a cold one that he hid in the closet. He had a cold one right before the fight. It ended, and whatever he took, he said his three-year-old daughter hits harder than Devin Haney. When Haney was hitting him in the back, he said it felt like a deep tissue massage. He didn't feel like any pain or anything bad. So here's some historic moments of Ryan Garcia backstage. After his epic win over Devin Haney. Devin Haney was one of the best pound-for-pound fighters, undisputed at 35, champ at 40. He beat the champ. Devin had a big performance with Regis. He took the 140 belt. He was a champion. And then Ryan comes in and ruins everything and just does it in fashion. He dropped Devin five times, three counted, two to referee Harvey, robbed Ryan from a knockout, robbed people who bet on the knockout. But nonetheless, Ryan Garcia shocked the world, and did, and he flipped the whole boxing world upside down, which is great for the sport. Boxing needed a big jolt. It needed a big earthquake. And Ryan Garcia, he's in the business of predicting earthquakes. He predicted this. I left a comment on his page 4 weeks ago saying, I will not be shocked when you beat Haney. Everybody else will be shocked, but I won't be shocked. And guess what? He shocked the world, but he didn't shock me. And by the way, people ask me, on Ryan's page, there's two or three people with fake accounts because they have no followers and whatever, and they asked me, well, why do you keep leaving comments here? Because if I didn't leave a comment there, who would have believed me? If I didn't leave a comment under Ryan's social that he's going to beat Devin, that he's going to knock out Devin, that he's going to beat and the new, because Devin should vacate the belt. And like Ryan said, hit up Mauricio and say, hey, give Ryan the belt. He won the fight. There's no way you should still be champion after taking such a beating. There's no way. You accepted the $1.5 million. It's a fair fight. Should have said, you know what? I'm not fighting you if you missed weight. I'm fighting Barbosa. But they already looked past Ryan. They're already lining up. But never look past your opponent. Always fight whoever is in front of you in the ring, and you have to think they're Mayweather in their prime. No one should ever take an opponent lightly. When I covered the Lakers, they would take the worst teams in the NBA lightly and get bitten in the ass. But they always fought great against the top-level competition. So Ryan, he made Devin fall asleep, and Devin really thought Ryan wasn't all that, although they're 3-3 in the amateurs. In the amateurs, Ryan busted Devin's eardrum, and I wouldn't be surprised if in the first punch that Ryan landed, that hook that wobbled Devin, he busted his eardrum again, and that, you know, he didn't have balance and he couldn't do anything, took him out of his game plan. So definitely was a historic night to remember. And it's wild because wherever I go these days, people are talking to me about Ryan Garcia, Devin Haney. Everyone, what's going to be next for Ryan? What's going to be next for Haney? Well, Devin Haney looks like he's going to be, right now he's suspended medically for 6 to 9 months. So, and even when he comes back, he's still champ. So he has to fight very, very tough competition. He needs to give up the belt and then fight low-level competition, fight some journeyman, fight some easy comeback fights to get his confidence up, to get himself on a high, on another level, to get ready to come back from what he just faced. And it's not going to be easy. He may never be the same. If he got knocked out in the first round, okay. Emmanuel Stewart said first round knockouts don't count. You could get caught cold. But he took a beating here. And the referee actually thought he's helping Devin. He made it worse for him. Should have stopped it in seven. Would have saved him from those embarrassing moments. The memes I've seen. I haven't seen so many memes since Andy Ruiz beat Joshua. Non-stop. Every day is 20 new memes of the way he went down, the way he was posing, the way he's this and that. It's just very hard to come back from it when before that you were flawless. You didn't jaywalk. There was not a lot of things they could say bad about you. When it comes to your boxing skills and your boxing ability, and everybody's telling me he's one of their favorite fighters and everybody enjoys watching him. I never thought Devin was all that myself, but I know boxing. But a lot of people, you know, they go with the hype. Oh, he's pound for pound. Oh, he's exciting. He's special. He's this. He's the new Mayweather. And a lot of people bought into that. Ryan has faced him so many times that he knew who Devin Haney was. And he wasn't falling for it. And he showed no respect. And he just wanted him more. It's like when Victor Ortiz fought Andre Berto. And the first time they fought, he just wanted him more. And there was nothing that was going to stop him. Sometimes you have to have those nights where you're an invincible force. And Ryan did it, and he should be proud of himself. He should be happy. The whole world was against him, whether by design or not. I saw he did a podcast where Ryan said, hey, I recorded something months ago where I said the whole world will be mad at me. So he kind of knew what he was doing, but he was still drinking every night, what fighters should not be doing. He was still cutting corners. Yes, when he trains, he was training. Like they say, Ryan needs help with everything except with fighting. He's good in that aspect. He knows how to fight. He doesn't look like a fighter, but he's a badass. And Ryan, when he got down to fight, he got down. He's not scared of no one. And you have to respect Ryan that he's willing to fight anyone, anywhere, anytime. And now he wants to fight Fundora. And I believe him, the 154 champion, who's 6'6" southpaw, has two belts at 154. Ryan wants him next, and Ryan believes he knocks him out. Ryan also wants to fight Earl Spence, who for many, many years was the king of the 147 division. Earl Spence is now going to move up to 54. And him and Ryan, if they fight, it will be for the title. He wants to fight Gervonta again, the pound for pound king, Gervonta Davis. Ryan wants a rematch. He wants a rematch at a bigger weight. Tank obviously is fighting June 15 against Frank Martin, who's the stablemate of Ryan. So have to wait and see first. But never put another fight in front of Haney. Was talking about already who he's fighting next. They wrote off Ryan, and look how that turned out. Not very good for them. So you always have to focus on the job at hand, not the future imaginary opportunity that may never come again. Because we don't know. What if Devin retires? What if Devin had enough of boxing, enough of all this, and he just walks away from the sport and lives the rest of his life. He made money. He keeps moving. He has nothing to prove anymore. He did everything that he had to do. So that's what Devin Haney does next. What does Ryan do next? He has so many options. But he wants to get back in the ring ASAP. Oscar De La Hoya mentioned yesterday that if Munguia... that Ryan's the face of boxing, but if Munguia beats Canelo, he'll have two faces of boxing. Munguia, Canelo, less than 2 weeks away. And of course, this weekend, you have Virgil Ortiz, one of the biggest names at 154. He's 20-0, 20 knockouts. He's already scheduled to fight Tim Zhu in August. But I saw comments that fans want to see Virgil and Ryan. They fought in the amateurs. Now they can fight in the pros. They have unfinished business. Just like Devin and Ryan had unfinished business. They were 3-3. That was a tiebreaker. You don't need a rematch right now. Because that's it. This was it. This was the rematch. This was the seventh time they fought. And it was a one side. It wasn't even competitive. The judge who scored at 112-112 should not be judging anything anytime soon. It was not close. And the two knockdowns that they robbed Ryan's with, that was a stoppage in the seventh round. So Ryan celebrating like you saw, 1.5 million on jewelry, like he's buying a stick of gum, like he's buying a pack of gum. Nothing. Like, okay, pocket change, 1.5 million, no worries, I got it. And that's a beautiful situation to be in. I don't recommend people to spend money on jewelry. Not right off the bat. I think when you make a lot of money, slow it down, pump the brakes. Most people who win the lotto go broke. So I never want to see anyone who was fortunate enough to make money go broke. Not saying that Ryan's going broke, because obviously I don't know his finances. And he said the whole time that he's worth 500 million. And I wish he's worth a billion. But definitely, you have to be very careful what you spend and how you spend. $150,000 ring, $50,000 ring is still expensive. And that's more than enough for someone that you're dating, unless you're, you know, married with a prenup and all that. So stay tuned. We'll keep you guys posted. But there you have it. Ryan Garcia, another day at the office, another day in the life of Ryan Garcia. Never boring, always entertaining, always knows how to get the big headlines. TMZ already posted, Ryan is with two different girls in one weekend in Vegas, in Miami, whatever. Stays headline, stays relevant, not easy to do. FayesNewsReporting.com, I'm Melissa back. reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter at Secback. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secback.
I'm Ellie Secback, Ellie Secback reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting. ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting.